Are you aware of the charges that you're facing here today?
Somewhat.
All right. Did you get a chance to review the indictment with Ms. Cooker?
A little bit, yeah.
All right. As I look at that indictment, it indicates that there are six separate counts. Counts 1, 3, 4, and 6 are each entitled tampering with evidence. They're felonies of the third degree. They have potential 9 to 36 month prison sentence. Up to $10,000 in fines could be imposed. Count 2 is gross abuse of a corpse, a felony of the fifth degree. 6 to 12 months in prison possible, up to a $2,500 fine. And count 5 is a charge of murder. It's an unclassified felony. It carries a 15-year-to-life sentence and up to a $20,000 fine. Are those then the penalties and the charges that you're aware you're facing? Do you have any prior felony convictions?
No.
Are you currently on supervision or probation anywhere?
No.
Do you understand that you have a right to have an attorney at this proceeding and all proceedings that go forward before the court?
Yes.
Can you afford your own attorney?
Yeah.
Do you have anybody in mind at this point? Have you talked to anyone?
I talked to one person, but I don't know what he said.
All right. Do you have any objection to Ms. Cooker assisting you for today's purposes for arraignment? If you do retain your own counsel, we're going to give you dates today. Obviously, we haven't cleared those with counsel that we don't know who they are at this point. So they would have to file a notice of appearance, and these dates that we give you may be subject to change based on their availability. But for now, they would be required for your attendance. If you want the court to appoint counsel for you, if you find that you can't afford counsel, you can fill out a financial disclosure form, turn that in, and the court could consider appointing counsel. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Do you have any assets of note, a house, property, those types of things? All right. Do you currently work?
No.
All right. Any sources of income that I should be aware of?
Not at the moment.
Okay. Typically, then, you would be able to qualify. So if you do change your mind and you want to apply for counsel, the court would be willing to appoint counsel for you. As far as your rights in this matter, do you understand that you have a right to remain silent with regard to these charges? And do you understand that you have a right to a trial by jury on these charges? And I need you to answer out loud with that.
Yes.
All right. And Ms. Cooker has a copy of the indictment that's served on the defendant?
Thank you, Your Honor. On behalf of Mr. Reer, I would acknowledge receiving a copy of the indictment and any further reading and enter pleas of not guilty to all counts on the indictment.
All right. And with regard to bond, Mr. Siddeley?
Thank you, Your Honor. State would be asking for a $1 million cash bond plus personal cognizance that the defendant not have any contact with the victim's family, that the defendant be subject to electronic ankle monitor, and that the court impose a curfew. State would also be asking that he be enrolled in pretrial services.
All right. And as the bond, Ms. Cooper.
Thank you, Your Honor. I do think the $1 million bond request is excessive. Your Honor, he's already indicated he has no prior felonies, non-supervised, or anything like that. I do understand the significance and severity of the alleged charge here. However, Your Honor, I do still think the $1 million is excessive. Otherwise, I think all the other requested terms and conditions of bond would be appropriate. And also, if he does hire counsel, we would ask that he be able to argue bond as well.
Your Honor, if I may supplement the state's request.
You may.
The state is asking this because Mr. Reer had previously resided in both California and Florida. In addition to the course exchanges that he had with the family before anyone last saw the victim.
All right. The court does not think the state's request is unreasonable. I will indicate, though, as you intend to retain counsel, I would leave the open as the argument for bond once you have retained counsel as well. But for today's purposes, I'm going to set it at the state's request, a $1 million bond because of course, only cognizance. Also, that if the bond were posted, you have no association with the victim's family. That means no contact of any type, no letter writing, no email, no social media, no going through third parties, and no in-person contact. If you find her in the same place as the victim, a member of the victim's family, it would be your duty to leave. Do you understand that requirement? And again, you can answer up loud.
Yes.
As far as the electronic monitoring, the court would also order that a GPS monitor would be used in addition. That would be on terms and conditions of house arrest. Also, pretrial services would be required, which would mean that you had to check in with our probation department for purposes of supervision while you were out on bond. They would provide the address and the time for that, the time of your release and posting the fine. As far as appearances, if you don't appear at the dates that we've set for you, that can be a felony of a fourth degree, and it can result in 18 months in prison. Do you understand that? As far as dates, then, we have a pretrial scheduled for March 11th, 2024 at 1 o'clock. A final pretrial will be at April 11th, 2024 at 1. And if a jury trial were necessary, that would be May 1st, 2024, and that would be at 12:30. We are going to ask that you sign in recognition of those conditions. I'm also going to ask that if you have an address and a phone number where you intend to reside, if you post bond, to include that as well. Do you understand that? Ms. Carter?
Your Honor, just on the judgment entry that was prepared, it says the date will be April 17th. You stated April 11th. I just want to clarify.
Oh, it's April 17th. Did I say 11th? Yes. I misspoke. It's April 17th.